you could want to make a billion-dollar empire, but start small, get it right, and then achieve your dreams, is what I have learned. Especially in the world of food, the money will follow, fame will follow, but you have to get that plate of food right. You have to get your soul right. Run after that. When I was growing up, I was always looked down upon as a person who wanted to cook. Yeah. It was nothing fancy. Yeah. Like if you wanted to become an engineer or a doctor, it was like you were given a lot of respect. Yeah. But agar chef banna hai, to acha kuch aur nahi hai, to you're going for hotel management. So I have learned to let go of people who create barriers in my journey. I kind of treat them as foundations to build something on. Every time somebody has looked down upon me because I wanted to become a chef, because I wanted to become an entrepreneur, because I wanted to be famous. And every time people question me, I tell them, boss, I am selling 2 lakh portions of butter chicken a year. Hmm. So,
please.
Matlab, ho gaya. I think for me now, growth parameter is people critiquing me.
What's good, you guys? Welcome to another entrepreneurial episode of The Ranveer Show. We've got my friend, FNB entrepreneur Saranj Goela, India's biggest and best butter chicken entrepreneur. Ooh. That's what I call it.
Biggest and best butter chicken entrepreneur. I think that's a new title to have. Like, best butter chicken entrepreneur. Sounds interesting, right?
You've gone from being a chef to becoming an all-out business person. And now you're also a social media celebrity. Someone who's like kind of glued up all three worlds, bro. So is it true that as an entrepreneur, there's a lot of potential in the F&B industry?
Cricket, Bollywood, religion and food are the biggest industries in this country. You know, if Bollywood makes 20,000 crores a year as a market, food does 120,000 crores a year. So we are 6 to 8 times bigger than Bollywood in size. Wow. So industry has massive potential. We are only growing 10% year on year as an industry on whole, whether it's a restaurant business, delivery business is growing by some 25 to 30% year on year. All the international investments are coming into India for the delivery market. So, bahut potential hai. Young entrepreneurs who want to make their mark in the food industry, this is the best time you have. It's a difficult industry to crack. But if you can crack it, then there is no looking back. Once your brand is liked by people, and that happens through food, if you have good food, which you can serve every day without fail, if you can crack that model, you are in for the long run.
You've gone from being like a chef who started at the lowest level, and then you started your own restaurant chain, you've gone on MasterChef. You've reached like what people perceive as like the top rung in like the industry. So how did this happen?
You know, I generally tell people, log kya kahenge has killed many dreams, but log kya khayenge has made many. When I was starting my journey, mujhe bahut sare log bolte the ki, are, don't dream so big.
Yeah, yeah.
You want to become Sanjeev Kapoor. Yeah. That does not happen in a night. Yeah. How can you ask to become somebody like that? So those are the kind of questions you get posed onto when you're thinking big, right? Mm-hmm. If you say, I want to be the biggest businessman in India, people will still ask me a question, you run a delivery restaurant, how can you be the biggest businessman in the country? Mm-hmm. But it's a dream, mm-hmm. right? I have a dream that I want to run a big brand that can travel across the globe. So that's where it stems out of. When I joined my HM college, I had a very clear-cut goal in my head that I am not somebody who wants to run in the who wants to work in a hotel in a stereotypical job where they guide me and they tell me aapko aaj ye banana hai. So since college I started making a map. I started studying Chef Sanjeev Kapoor's legacy and how he became one of the most popular global chefs, not only Indian chefs. And what I saw out of his journey was that he was very focused. He taught all of us what does a chef's life look like and what can he do. I had my first job at the Leela in Bangalore. I told my dad that I am not very happy with the fact that I work so hard, I put in 14 hours a day. I might as well work for my own self and make more money because I know that I can cook. and I know that I have the skill. So then why should I not go out and do it myself?
So bro, before Goila, you actually had another business that had failed. And this is something a lot of entrepreneurs don't talk about enough, that to become a good entrepreneur, you actually need to have a few failures. What's the biggest thing you learned from your failure?
You can't be a know-it-all. When I was growing up to be a chef, I used to think, "Arey, mujhe sab maloom hai. I know everything about this industry. I am ready to do my business." And I did it. I had the confidence. But my first catering company, which I started after I quit my job at the Leela, shut in 15 months of it opening. And the hard reality of that was that I wasn't ready. Every time that you're starting a business, it's okay to spend some time doing research and building it up versus just jumping into it and being like, "Arey,
meko aata hai, main karunga."
I think that was my failure in the first go, and I've learned from it. That has helped me grow Butter Chicken to where it is today.
What's the plan going forward with the Goila Butter Chicken brand? You want to become like an international brand? Like, what's happening there?
Absolutely. That was a thought from the first day that I decided to start this venture. As a chef, I could have easily opted to open a fine dining restaurant and having had run it in Mumbai. But my dream was that I want to make Indian food proud. I want to change the way our food is treated across the globe. With Goila Butter Chicken, I know it sounds like Goila Butter Chicken, but once we grow and once we go across the globe, we will have many more things in our company. We will have many more things in our restaurants to educate people about Indian khana. We will have books that educate them about our food. We will have dishes that represent different parts of our community. We are not just a butter chicken country, of course not. India cannot be about one dish from one region. And the idea is to take Goila Butter Chicken to the globe and feed them good Indian khana and something that they haven't tried before.
So bro, they say that the Sanjeev Kapoor brand is worth 2,000, 3,000 crores.
Easily.
Do you have your eyes set on that kind of a target?
100%. This year, I saw his name on the Forbes list.
Yeah.
He was 32. Number 32 amongst all cricketers and Bollywood stars, and it makes us so proud. At least it makes me so proud as a chef that another chef has been able to take our industry to that level where people should know, "Arey, ye khane ke, it's not a samosa patti and a chai selling
ye business. Ji,
haan, ye, you know, we have gone through this transition. Tum bawarchi banoge to beta, you want to become a chef." My parents, siblings and all these uncles, aunts used to ask, "Arey, aapka beta bawarchi banega." Now everybody's like, "Oh, he's a chef." Big restaurant brands in the country are worth 1,000 crores, are worth 500 crores. So these numbers are not shams or lies. This industry has immense amount of potential, and I take inspiration from Chef Sanjeev. I hope to see myself on that Forbes list someday with Goila Butter Chicken and with my other businesses.
What's the worst thing of this whole journey till now, from the time you became a chef till today?
Ooh, I think the worst thing of my journey is people looking down upon me. That's been my biggest battle to fight, because every time somebody has looked down upon me because I wanted to become a chef, because I wanted to become an entrepreneur, because I wanted to be famous, and for all these three different parts of my life, I've always been cross-questioned by somebody around me. Every time I voice out my ideas, they're always shunned. And every time people question me, I tell them, "Boss, I am selling 2 lakh portions of butter chicken a year. So,
please.
Matlab, ho gaya." But then you have to wake up to criticism every day. And I think that's also my greatest motivator. Now, if people are not critiquing me, I feel I'm doing some, I've become stagnant where I'm not growing. I think for me now, growth parameter is people critiquing me.
So how do you feel about like those haters and doubters now?
You know, honestly, if you're honestly asking me, sometimes I want to just f*** you. And that's what I would like to tell them. That by the same time, I've also learned that you have to be humble. If you're growing in life, every person comes into your life for a reason. Maybe they had a different mindset and they had a different journey to question your journey. So you have to give that slight benefit of doubt to that person or to the person who questioned you on your journey. It could be a person who's really close to you also. So I have learned to let go of people who create barriers in my journey. I kind of treat them as foundations to build something on. It's taken me many years, but that's what I've learned, that every critic or every critique that you get for whatever you do in life, you have to learn something off it. Sometimes it also benefits you. Sometimes a person might also be right. So, yeah, so you, but okay.
But thanks.
Yeah.
Nice. I like that vibe. So bro, you've overcome so many people who doubted you. What is your advice to that 18-year-old, 19-year-old who's going through that same thing in life that you went through?
Bahut simple hai. You have to, by default, follow your dream and passion without listening to what people tell you. As I said, log kya kahenge does not matter. You have to believe in your dream. If you don't, then who will? If you start questioning your own dream, then you can never create something new in life. Don't give up, because eventually everything falls in place. There is a reason for every failure. You can always look back to it and be like, agar ye nahi hua hota to main yahan pahunchta hi nahi. And that's what I have seen in my journey. Money will follow you. If you are somebody who knows, I can do this, boss, I can make it big, I can come up with something that nobody else has come up with, I can open a restaurant that nobody has seen in this city, or I can sell a product that you don't see on any shelf, whether you go to any grocery or retail store. So if you have that confidence and if you have that energy and if you have that knowledge within you, you cannot set yourself an upper limit.
Saranj Goela,
amazing man.
I hope you had fun on the interview.
I am literally now, you've put so many thoughts in my head. So I am thinking about a lot of things as well.
I'm glad. Guys, I'm going to be linking Saranj's handles as well as his YouTube channel down below. Make sure you subscribe, make sure you follow. And until next time, guys, from Ranveer, the team, and Saranj, we'll see you later.